Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and please join me in thanking Anthony Chen for providing the beautiful music for us this evening. And earlier on, Veronica Lambert played the carillon for us as we gathered in this wonderful hall. So thank you to Veronica. I'm Stephen Garten. I'm the Provost and Deputy Vice-Chancellor of this wonderful university, and it's an honour to welcome you all to the Great Hall for this momentous occasion. Before we begin proceedings, I would like to acknowledge and pay respect to the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation, and it's upon their ancestral lands that this founding campus of the University of Sydney is built. And as we share our knowledge, teaching, learning and research practices within this university, may we also pay respect to the knowledge embedded forever within Aboriginal custodianship of country. And of course, it's inspiring for all of those of us who work here to know that the creation and transmission of knowledge has been going on here for tens of thousands of years. Well, we are here tonight to celebrate the gift of new light being brought to our beloved Great Hall. Designed by the colonial architect Edmund Blackett, construction of the Great Hall commenced in 1854 and was officially opened in 1859, although the splendid marble floor we walk across today was not laid for another 16 years. At the time, Parliament questioned why the university needed grand and ornate sandstone buildings for an institution that only had an annual enrolment of 50 students. But our founders had vision and foresight and could see what was to come. Although they might not have envisioned the 60,000 students, but they knew this was the beginning of something great. The university, as a consequence, persisted with its plan, and since then the Great Hall has played a special role in thousands of people's lives. Tonight marks a new chapter for the Great Hall as we reveal and celebrate the new lighting system. The first lights in the hall were gas-powered and were installed on the opening in 1859, and it was not until 1928 that electrical lighting was installed. The lights were refurbished in 1965, and today, as the result of another generous gift, the lighting capacity has been brought from a mere 40 lux to over 300 lux, and has the technical capabilities to cater for the multiple uses of the hall. I would now like to invite the Vice Chancellor and Principal Dr. Michael Spence to the stage.
Thank you. I don't think I've ever stood here and it'd be quite so bright. I'd also like to begin by acknowledging the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, the Gadigal people of the Eora Nation. As Stephen says, it is remarkable that people have been teaching and learning in this place for a very long time indeed. And we're recovering the history of this location and the stories associated with its Aboriginal as well as its European past. Well, Stephen mentioned that the electrical lights were installed here in the hall in 1928. That was also as a result of a philanthropic gesture from the Electrical Employers Association. It was a remarkable thing that the facility should have electric lights. But this is a whole new phase. This building is important in so many ways in the life of the university. And to have the flexibility to use it in the way that we are going to be able to use it, lighting it in ways that are appropriate to the different sorts of events here, is just something very special indeed. And we owe an enormous debt of gratitude to the King family for their support for this project, and of course to Barry Webb, whose conception it was, whose design it was, and whose work will really speak for itself this evening, as you see what a magical place he can make this. And it is a magical place. There are so many details in the hall that I did not see until I saw the trial of, or the demonstration of Barry's lighting. And so in those endlessly dull graduate notes, sorry, you're not allowed to say that, we will have the opportunity to see the crests, to see the windows in their glory, to see the paintings in new detail. And so the university does owe a very great debt of gratitude to Barry for giving new, fresh life to this remarkable facility and to the King family for their support of the university. Thank you.
Now it's my honour to be tasked with revealing the new light that has been brought to the Great Hall. But I do need some help. Representing the King family, can I ask Oliver King to the stage? And bringing a new light to the hall, also are Barry Webb's granddaughters, Laura Wunderlich and Jessica Stathakis. Some distinct features that until now have been in shadow. The Oxford window. You can see at the top of the window are the arms of Queen Victoria, Sir Charles Nicholson, and the University of Sydney, as well as the university motto. The lion and the unicorn are the supporters of the royal arms. Below are bishops and royalty. Below each figure are the coats of arms of Oxford colleges, the angels. There are 12 wooden angels carved in cedar. 7 represent subjects that comprise the 7 liberal arts in medieval times. 3 angels represent the philosophies, and the final pair above the dais represent the symbol of learning. The coats of arms, which represent the various universities in the British Isles and in the Australian colonies when the hall was built. Each portrait of our distinguished chancellors, vice-chancellors, benefactors, and early professors have been individually illuminated with care and consideration given to how many lux they are exposed to, ensuring that they can be enjoyed by generations to come. Thanking them once more. outstanding musical performances from the Conservatory of Music and friends of the university to celebrate this momentous occasion. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ben Adler. Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Evan Kirby, accompanied by Anthony Chin.
Thank you.
thank you to the choir of the Sydney University Musical Society. It was simply wonderful. What better way to begin tonight's remarkable celebration? I'd now like to ask all of the performers to come to the stage, our talented musical students and the volunteers. Anthony Chen on piano. Ben Adler on violin. Soprano Zoe Bruckner. Tenor Evan Kirby. Rock Act on violin. Oh, no, organ, sorry. I'll never be finished that. And the Sydney University Musical Society Choir. So, ladies and gentlemen, that brings a close to tonight's formalities. Thank you all for being a part of this special night. It's been one to remember. Drinks and canapes will continue, so please stay and enjoy the transformation the lighting project has made to this great hall. Good evening, thank you very much.